Hello everyone, this is Ahmed Dan of AhmedDan.com. Today I will have another episode of Toronto Walk video, and I will start from the western corner of Front Street towards the end of other end of Front Street, which is going to be east part of Front Street, and so it runs from Bathurst Street to Bayview, and it's about 4 kilometers. So this is let me show you around the start point a little bit. So the bridge you're looking at, this is the Bathurst Bridge. It's about 125 years old bridge. They just reconstructed the bridge, however they didn't change the frame, so I have a guess that the bridge is good to go for another probably 100 years. And then you're looking at the stacked market, which is made of entirely cargo containers, and there are lots of stores inside, and due to COVID some of them are closed, but still I see people are going in. And this is the Bathurst Street going northbound towards Bathurst Station, and right now we are on the corner of Front and Bathurst. So I'll start walking towards this side, east way, and this is going to be about 4 kilometers. And I'm not sure that I will be able to finish the whole Front Street, but we'll see. So I'm hoping to reach towards the end, which is going to be at Bayview. And just another glimpse of the bridge right from here. So from here you have a good view of Toronto downtown, and you're looking at the CN Tower, and on the right side you can see that the city place, and then the tracks are underneath the right, on the right the GO train and UP and VIA train tracks all heading towards the Union Station. So in today's video, I'll be talking once in a while, not all the time, and it's a beautiful day, very sunny, but it's cold. The temperature is sitting around minus 13, minus 15 in that range, and it's windy, so I have to wear gloves, otherwise, the fingers would freeze. So you can see a beautiful bridge going to City Place, and there's some nice buildings over there. So we're going to cut through downtown Toronto. There will be lots of buildings, stores on the way. Usually this is a busy street, and the Front Street is about 225 years old, so this is one of the Toronto's oldest streets. And it's a nice street to walk. But you can see lots of constructions here and there. On the corner of Courtland and Front. And let me show you this part of the street a little bit. So a very good view of CN Tower and some new skyscrapers. just a quick view of the building which are attached by the, it could be their swimming pool or just, you know, a passage to go from one building to another building, but it looks very nice. And this is the white building I was talking before. So this is City Place you're looking at. Draper Street, and I can see some old buildings here. So constructions everywhere, and they made the pathway to pass by. And you're looking at the Rogers Center. So the upcoming street is Spadina, and I have a feeling there shouldn't be any construction after Spadina, so the view should get better. And my work videos, I try to do all at once, and I try not to cut anything in the middle. So what you're looking at is going to be the one work. And I might cut it just, you know, a little piece here and there, but usually I try not to cut anything. So let's see how far we can go. I don't see many people today out on the street due to COVID stay home order. The side of Spadina is going to Chinatown. wind is making the cold worse. On the street, but it's not, you know, a lot. You can feel the emptiness. Passing by the Domino's and Tim Hortons. So the corner of Blue Jays Way and Front Street. Once I pass the street, I'll show you the other side of Blue Jays. So let's start with a good look of the CN Tower. Looks like you have a very good view from here. And this is the other side of Blue Jays. Windsor Street, a small street.
It's all over.
Yonge Street. We are cutting through Entertainment District in downtown Toronto, and here's a view of Yonge Street on the other side. This looks like a CBC station. So CBC is Canadian television channel, which has lots of good programs, and they have very good news. And it looks like one of their studios, Canadian Broadcasting Corporation, CBC. So my right hand fingers are getting numb, although I have heavy gloves, but still, you know, cold is getting through. So I'm going to just switch my hand, and let me switch to my left hand. So there's a small park, it's called Simcoe Park. Lower Simcoe Street is coming up. Restaurants are all closed. Some restaurants are offering takeout. So we are passing, it looks like a nice restaurant. So this is the corner of Simcoe and Front. Construction again. Let me just show you a little bit. Delta Hotel.
for the soup.
So there's a skyscraper, looks like a boat. That's cool designing. Nice architecture. So University Avenue is coming up. Bike share station, you can rent any bike by the hours. They have even annual subscription plan. So from here you can go to different directions. Entertainment district, which you just passed, then harbor front, and then here the Discovery district leading to St Andrew Station, 4 minute walk. So this is the intersection of York University and Front, and we're going to pass Union Station on our right. York Hotel, and let's show you the other side of York Street. Union Station on our right. And the York Hotel entrance is going to be on the left coming up. This is the Royal York Hotel entrance. So let's take a quick look at the Union Station facade. So Canadian Pacific Railway Union Station, erected by the Toronto Terminal Railway Company. This is very old. And stretches a few blocks. Another part of Royal York Hotel entrance. Actually, this could be the front entrance. This is a way leading to the path underground network. So whole Toronto has, or Toronto downtown has underground path or underground connected system, and they're like, you know, this, it's a different world. There are shopping malls, coffee shops, restaurants, everything underground, and you can pass from one part of Toronto to another part just if you take the underground pathways. That can be another video one day. Corner of Bay Street in front. Take a quick look of other side of Bay. So right now I'm not feeling really cold. It could be that, you know, I walked a little bit, body's warming up, and I feel wind is slightly reduced. It's not windy that much, so that can be another reason. So you're passing through Toronto Financial District. Lots of big banks, their headquarters, financial companies, all are located in this area. Yonge Street is coming up. Hall of Fame. So if you need to read this, you can just pause later on and then read it. So this is the Yonge Street. Let me show you the other side of Yonge Street a little bit. This is the longest street in the world. It goes up north far away. I'm not sure exactly how long it is or where it stops, but it's a really long street. And it kind of runs in the middle of the downtown, cutting through north-south. So on the right, St. Lawrence Center for the Arts. And the Canadian Stage Company, Luma. And you can see some nice artwork here. So for example, those two hands sticking out. And here there's a cat on top of the structure. So some other artwork, looks like lots of dogs, and they're all looking at dog bones on the top. So let's have a quick look. Actually, at first from a distance I thought they're really dogs. You can see the milk bone.
Yes, yes.
A nice place to hang out. I can see some people are actually enjoying the weather and the sunny day. So there's a nice artwork here. So it's just like a kind of a building on another building, that's the way the art made. Church Street coming up. So it looks like there's no pedestrian crossing right here, so we're gonna have to just like, you know, cross here and then I can move to the other side. Empty street. Just wait here a little bit to go to the other side of the street. Somehow I have a feeling that I'll have better view on the other side. And looks like there's no cars coming, so I can just go ahead and cross the street. And the walk sign is on. So this is the Wellington Street. And this actually, it's a nice view because the streets kind of are splitting on two sides. St. Lawrence Market, it's a very old market in the heart of downtown Toronto, and in the past there used to be farmers market kind of thing on the weekend, but I'm not sure they still have that, most likely not due to the COVID situation. So there's an old theater or cinema, and surprisingly they're open. You have to just wear masks and you have to purchase tickets online. So here's the St. Lawrence Market.
How are you feeling? How's the day going so far?
Construction again. Jarvis Street. Let me just show you a little bit on both sides of Jarvis Street. George Street. So you can see that the sceneries are changing. So no more tall new skyscrapers. This is the old part of town. Frederick Street. Just got hit by a nice meal from the restaurant and it made me feel like start eating. Side. There's a gas station, so it's very, you'll hardly come across any gas station in downtown Toronto. And the other side of Sherbourne Street. Princess Street.
Hello.
This is a lineup to the groceries right here.
Do I have to report you?
And how do you feel about the view?
Looks like a very old building. Canadian opera company.
Third chance to grab something.
I didn't have to load my cigarettes. I disagree with others.
Berkeley Street. So let me show you around to the sites. So this building looks like it has some sort of nice designing. Parliament Street. Other side of Front Street, I mean Parliament Street. So this is becoming Eastbound Avenue, and Erin Street is coming up, so I'm gonna have to change road right here or just a little bit ahead. So it looks like Eastbound Avenue starts right here, and this is Georgetown and Parktown merging place, and we have Trinity Street. So there's an opportunity to cross, which I'll cross right here. And then I'm going to cross here again. So this is Trinity Street. This area is quieter and not many skyscrapers. So since I started doing walking videos, I've seen many places in Toronto which I have never seen before, because I didn't have to actually go to that many places. So this is a good opportunity to even see new places and show you guys what's out there. Cherry Street. We have the lock sign, let's see if I can cross it. And I can show you both sides while I'm crossing. So at some point the front street is going to end, but I'm not sure how far is this, but shouldn't be that far. Bridge Street. Looks like a nice residential area, quite still in downtown. It's a nice complex here. It looks like they try to make an artwork with lights and stuff. Looks cool. There's another artwork. If I'm not mistaken, it looks like a couple and a kid. So surprisingly, we are close to the end of Front Street. I can see Bayview Avenue from here. That's where Front Street ends, on the east side. And we started at Bathurst and Front on the west side. So that's the whole Front Street. So we walked about 4 kilometers. I'm not keeping an eye on the watch, so I don't know how much time I spent, but should be 40 minutes, 1 hour, in that range. Looks like there's some more artwork which we'll take a look at. Cannery Road, just passed. Nice, quiet neighborhood. I kind of like this type of, you know, neighborhood. You can sit here and unwind and just, you know, enjoy the solitude. So there's some nice artwork here. And Corktown Common Park on the other side. And if you look on the right, there's a GO station, or it could be just a GO train. Another glimpse of the area. And look at the artwork. And you have a nice view of downtown from here. So this is where I'm going to end my video. Thank you for watching. There'll be more walking videos coming up. So we passed about 4 kilometers, the beginning to end of Front Street, cutting through downtown Toronto. And the video length should be, although I'm not watching my clock, but I have an idea of 45 minutes to 1 hour. So I'll see you in the next video. Thank you for watching.